Hello everyone. In last topic we have done types of mixtures differences in solution, colloid and suspension. Solution is also known as a true solution. True solution term is also known as used for a homogeneous mixture, that is solution, and suspension, colloid, which is also known as a sol. Their properties and differences we have done. Solution already we have done in detail, and suspension whatever we have done in differences, that is much. Next is colloid. Here types of colloids are important in your book, so today we will discuss colloid topic. First of all, what are colloids? Colloids are heterogeneous mixtures which appear homogeneous, and their particle size is between 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer. That is, the particle size of colloid is between true solution and suspension. True solution particles are smaller than colloid, and suspension particles are bigger than colloid particles. Okay, next. Colloid is also known as a sol. So different type of colloids are present. Example is given here. For example, hydrosol. Hydro word is used for water. Sol means colloid. Means the colloid which is made in water. Alcosol. Alco word is used for alcohol. The colloid used made in alcohol. Aerosol. Aero word is used for air. The colloid made in air. In detail we will do in here. Okay, so this word sol. On basis of phases, in solution we have done, solution is made when solute is mixed in solvent. Same here, colloid is made when dispersed phase is mixed in dispersion medium. Here solute and solvent terms are not used because these are used in solution. But to understand you, I have written it. Dispersed phase is similar to solute. That means which is small in quantity and their particles are present in the dispersion medium. Dispersion medium can be compared as solvent, which is more in quantity and it is in continuous phase. Let's take one example. If storm is there, storm means dusty air when comes. So storm is a type of colloid. Example, in this dispersed phase, that means which is less in quantity, is dust. Dispersion medium, that is more in air. So in storm, dust is present in air. Okay. Next, on basis of solvent attraction, that means when we mixed dispersed phase, then it will properly dissolve in dispersion medium or not. On that basis, due to solvent attraction, colloids are of two types, lyophilic and lyophobic. Here lyo word is used for solvent and philic means loving. Maybe you have listened the term hydrophobic and hydrophilic in bio when plasma membrane you do. Okay. Lyophobic, phobic means fear, means hating. So in a lyophilic, dispersed phase is solvent loving. That means solvent will properly remain, so this dispersed phase will properly remain in solvent. As we add starch in water, then we can see milky water. That means this dispersed phase properly remains in dispersion medium. Okay. Next is lyophobic. Here, dispersed phase is hitting dispersion medium. So they not remain together. The particles of dispersed phase not spread in dispersion medium. For example, metal in water. When you put a piece of metal in water, then metal not mix in that. Particles of metal remain together, or they just separate. Water remains separate from metal. This one clear? Okay. Now the most important part in collide is types of collides. So, if it is clear to you dispersed phase and dispersion medium, we can discuss this properly. Dispersed phase, that means which is less in quantity. For your help, I am writing here. It is same as solute. Okay. Dispersion medium, which is more in quantity. We have to add dispersed phase in dispersion medium. Same as solvent. Type. These are the name given to collide type. And next is written example. Okay. So first one is gas in liquid. When we add gas in a liquid, then it is called foam. The type of collide becomes foam. An example is gas in a liquid. Okay. Sometimes when you mix detergent or liquid detergent in water, after that when you shake it with hand or with some container, that water, then air particle goes inside that and bubbles form. And we call that foam is formed there. So that is soap lather. Soap also, when we rub soap and water, then what happened? Bubbles are formed and this is called lather. Okay. This lather, L-A-T-H-E-R, is different from another animal lather. Okay. So, when gas is present in liquid, it is called foam. Second, when gas is present in solid, it is called solid foam. Solid foam. An example is sponge. Means, when we take one sponge, gas particles goes inside the solid, that sponge, and it remains fluffy. When we squeeze that foam sponge, then air particles comes out. So sponge is a kind of a solid foam. Here you can see that if gas is the dispersed phase, then type of collide is called foam. Difference is simply in liquid it is simply foam and in solid it is solid foam. Okay. Next part is liquid in gas. When we dissolve some kind of liquid in gas, then it is called aerosol. Aerosol. Aero means air. Air is present in more quantity. Here also I took the example for storm also. Dust is present in air. Okay. So, it was solid and here it is liquid. Aerosol. Example of aerosol is cloud and fog. Just see 1 minute. When this liquid comes out, you can see it in air. See this one. You can see. So fog is also like this. When liquid particles comes in gas or air or atmosphere, then it is called aerosol. In clouds also, water vapors are there. Next, when liquid is present in a liquid, when dispersed phase is liquid and dispersion medium is also liquid, it is called emulsion. Emulsion. The example of emulsion is milk. In milk, milk is also there and fat particles are also there. So that dissolved fat particles or liquid fat particles are present in liquid milk. It is called emulsion, means liquid is present in liquid. Or if we put water in milk or milk in water, means we are adding two kinds of liquids, then it becomes emulsion, because different type of fat particles, sugar particles, milk, all remain inside that. Another example of emulsion is medicine. So when we add one syrup in water or one liquid medicine in water, then that medicine remains inside that. Sometimes it forms clear solution and sometimes it forms colloids. So which form colloids? That medicines only. They are examples of colloid, this emulsion. Next is, liquid is present in solid. Means now we have to mix liquid in solid. Solid is more and liquid is less in quantity. The type of colloid formed is called gel. Hair gel also you have listened, maybe you have used also. Curd, cheese, butter or jellies, eating jellies. Okay, so these all are examples of gel colloid. Next is for solids. When solid is present in gas, solid is dissolved in gas, then it is known as solid aerosol. Now see, gas, liquid in gas is simple aerosol, solid in gas, solid aerosol, same as we have done in form. Okay, so if gas is a dispersion medium, then it is always aerosol. Example of aerosol is smoke or storm. In storm, I show you, I tell you here that dust particles are present in air. Same, you can see the smoke. This smoke coming out, it completely goes in air. Later on, when this gas spreads, then it completely mixes. But when it is coming out, that time it is called solid aerosol. Here some particles, some solid particles, carbon particles are also there, which are coming in air. In home also you have seen, when you burn something, then what happened? Black particles of that thing, even you burn paper also, very light black particles or carbon particles comes in air and floating in air. That time that solid is present in gas. Okay, so this is example of solid aerosol. Next is, when solid is present in liquid, when solid is present in liquid, this is called sol, simply sol, as the term we have used for colloids, simply sol. The example of sol is mud, paint, etc. Mud, muddy water you have listened. When we add soil in water, that time water is more and soil particles are less. We are not including here that one. Okay, that is suspension. But when soil is more and less amount of water is mixed in that, means more we add solid here, then what happens? Muddy water becomes, and in that that mud particles not settle down. When mud particles not settle down, it is not called suspension, it is called collide. Okay, so mud is an example of soil. In paint also, we add paint in oil, kerosene oil sometimes, to make it thin and paint properly. Okay, so when solid is added in liquid, it is called paint. You have seen when to protect iron from rusting, red paint is done on it. That time also we do this, that red paint is in liquid form or solid powder form, it is mixed in liquid and the sole is made. Okay, the last one is solid in solid. When solid is added in solid, how it is possible? Directly if we add a solid in solid form with another solid, it is not possible to mix them properly. So what we do, we melt these two solids and then mix together, and again it becomes solid after some time. Example, this is called solid sole. Example of solid sole is alloy or gemstones. Alloy we have done simply in home, you have seen stainless steel. Here carbon, nickel, manganese, chromium and iron. These all are mixed together and they all exist in solid form in nature. They are melted and mixed together and then new substance is made. That is called stainless steel, one example of alloy. That is an example of solid sole collide type. Next is gemstone. What is gemstone? This type of stones. In gemstones, colored particles are added to glass particles and then given them colored appearance. The colored glass is used in sometimes in bathrooms. That colored glasses are also example of solid sole. The last one is the applications or uses of collides, where these are used. As in the form of milk, it is used as food. In medicines, milk of magnesia, Eno, etc. It is also type of collide. Paint to provide rusting. In daily life we use this collide. Coagulation. Coagulation is the process in which particles combine together and settle down. And this coagulation property is used here. Collides are made. First one, purification of water, where in water which is not pure, some soil particles are there, muddy particles are there, we add potash alum to purify it. Then precipitates are formed, soil particles settle down, becomes heavy. Delta formation is also an example of collide. It is done by coagulation process in which dust particles settle down, make solid part and then delta formation occurs. This was all about collides. Thank you.